In this vlog, we would like to continue with our tutorial on Flutter Drift Database. So in our previous tutorial, we have seen the basic introduction to the Drift Database, and also there we have tried to create a table and try to insert the data and fetch the data as well. So if you have not gone through that particular tutorial, I suggest you to go through that particular tutorial before getting started with this tutorial, because we are just continuing the same tutorial here. And we are going to add an additional concept to our database, which is joins here. So we are going to fetch the data from both the tables and try to print it on our console. I was getting few comments regarding this particular topic to be done with the Drift database. So I'm adding this particular tutorial. So now let's try to see the basic overview of joins here and what are we going to do in this particular tutorial. It might sound a new topic for few of you, and few of you are already aware of this particular topic, joins in database, but as we are covering this particular tutorial for the beginners, I want to add a few intro points regarding the joins here. So now let's try to see what we are trying to perform in this particular tutorial. We are going to have two tables here. The names of the tables will be like products and details here. And with the help of a joins, we are going to compare two rows here and try to fetch the information from both the rows, from both the tables, with the help of these particular rows here. So it might sound a little bit confusing for you, but stay tuned till the end of this tutorial and you will get a very good clarity on what are joins and how do we implement in Drift database. So this is our first table, that is products here, and inside this particular products we are going to have three columns like ID, title and description. So these are the three columns we are going to have in our first table, that is products. And let us consider our second table, which is details here, and the details table will have ID again, and we have name here, and also we have a product ID here. So what is a product ID again? We have separately a products table, right? And what is this product ID again in our details table here? So product ID is nothing but the same ID which we are going to specify in our products table here. So that particular ID we are storing in our details table as well to establish a relation how we will get this particular product ID. Now whenever we try to insert a data into our products table, then we are going to fetch the ID and store the ID when we are trying to insert data into our details table. And one point to be noted here, in both products table and details table, ID is auto incremented value. So we are not going to specify any ID value manually. And also you can do it by just removing the auto increment field. That's all. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial and try to see in deep level implementation of the Drift database and also joins concept.